day. Tell me who shall be able to stand. Yes, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Oh, yes, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Oh, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Tell me who shall be able to stand. Oh, let him get you ready for that great day. Oh, just let him get you ready for that great day. Yes, let him get you ready for that great day. Tell me who shall be able to stand. Oh, yes, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Oh, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Yes, Jesus, getting us ready for that great day. Tell me who shall be able to stand. Lord, I want to be ready for that great day. Oh, yes, I want to be ready for that great day. I want to be ready for that great day. Tell me who shall be able to stand. Praise the Lord to all the saints. The Lord is truly getting us ready for that great day. We're going to stand at this time before the Lord in prayer together. Amen. Just let us stand. God's going to help us, bless us even on tonight. Amen. By sending his precious word that we need each and every day. Amen. 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 We're thinking and praising the Lord. He's blessing right now. Pastors out of the hospital, God is blessing.
Amen.
Amen. We want you to continue. Send your prayers up. Continue to pray for all those that are sick among us. Those that are not able to be here in the service. God will continue to strengthen each one. Bless each one. Give us what we need. God's going to send the word because he knows what we need better than we know. Pray for all the leaders and here and everywhere. God will continue to bless and send his word to the men of God and the women of God. Pray for Apostolic Church of Jesus as a family. The Lord will help us to unite more and more together in unity and in strength. Souls on the altar, remember them and our children. God will protect them and keep them. Give them that desire to want to be in the house of the Lord. Right now, we want you to feel free. Make your request known one to another. Just a moment. Amen. Sister Tiffany.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm asking the saints to pray that God gives me more understanding of the reading of his word. And to, I would like to also pray for my family in its entirety. Special prayer for LaMarco and Micaiah and my parents.
Amen. Praise the Lord, sis.
I just want to pray for me and a very special
prayer. Amen.
Continue to pray for me. Continue to pray for those that seek in the Holy Ghost. Continue to pray for Keon in a very special way. Kiara in a very special way. Continue to pray for Detroit Public Schools. Continue to pray for those that is like really depressed and don't want to live any longer. Pray for Brother Hope.
Amen. 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 We want you to just continue to pray for the Lord to help us receive his knowledge. When you lose your desire to want to live, it's a lack of knowledge of the Word of God.
Yes.
You just don't understand what you're thinking about doing. Is that right?
That's right.
Pray for all the saints. God will enrich us with more knowledge. Amen. And more love for one another. We need more love. We really can't get enough. Reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. You will find he's not too busy, that he won't hear your heart's cry. He is passing by each moment. All your needs he will supply. So reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. Let's all pray.
Hallelujah.
Oh, dear Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we give thanks, glory, praise, and honor, Lord, to thy precious name tonight. We thank you for blessing us again that we can come and enter into your house to magnify you, Lord, to lift you up. Hallelujah. We thank you tonight, Lord, for blessing, hallelujah, our pastor to come out of the hospital. We thank you, oh God, for blessing his family. We ask that thou will continue, Lord, to send your healing virtue. Hallelujah. Touch the hearts and the minds of thy people everywhere, Lord Jesus. Help us, oh God, more and more to unite together. Hallelujah. And bind us together with your love and with the Spirit of the Lord tonight. Bless your word to come forth. Bless, hallelujah, the teacher tonight in the name of Jesus. Help us, oh God, to be on one accord to thy glory, to thy praise. We thank you today, Lord, for keeping us all day long. Hallelujah. We thank you for the Spirit of God down in our souls tonight. Yes, Lord. Help us, Lord, and lead and direct us, Lord, into thy perfect, hallelujah, that perfect knowledge, hallelujah, that we may continue in it in the name of Jesus. That we may know the truth, because the truth will make us free. Hallelujah. We thank you for it tonight. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for the blood. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for healing our bodies. Thank you, Lord, encourage the hearts of thy people everywhere in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, that we'll lift up holy hands. Hallelujah, we may continue, Lord, in thy will. Bless us, Lord, with strength tonight. Hallelujah, with a double mind determined to walk with thee, Jesus. We thank you for all the blessings. Answer each and every request tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to have a few minutes of testimony service. Feel free to praise the Lord. Give God some glory. Sister Moulton.
Praise
the Lord. Let me say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, brother.
Praise the Lord. I thank you that you woke me up today. I thank you for all that you have given me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, Sister Tiffany.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm thanking the Lord for waking me up this morning. I'm all thanking the Lord for keeping me all throughout the day. I'm thanking the Lord for keeping my hands behind my head. Behind my back, shall I say. When children do things they just ought not do. Thank you, Jesus. They just do things, and I'm just thankful that I didn't touch anybody. It's hard.
Amen.
It's hard.
Amen.
It's hard, yes. And it's hard. They do it, and then they look at you.
Yes.
Like, you know what you're doing. So I'm just thanking the Lord for giving me the strength to go on, to go to another day with four-year-olds. Pray my strength to the Lord.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
Let's just smile about it.
Yes.
You have practical to. Jokes they play. Amen.
No jokes. They do stuff they don't
have
to do.
They do.
Amen.
I worked in the school system before, and I remember they used to do a lot of things, matter of fact.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Just to Tracy.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I just wanted to thank God for another day, another second, another hour, another year. I thank God that I'm learning to zip my mouth because, not because of her case, the kids, but people on the job just can irk your nerves so bad. I just learned to smile and act like, you know, it don't bother me. It do, but I just don't show it. And I'm just learning that God is changing me because I can feel it. Deep down in my soul.
Thank you, Jesus.
Pray my strength in the Lord.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
I got the answer for you. Tell Jesus all about it.
Yes, ma'am, every night.
Hallelujah. Put it in his hands and leave it right there. And God will give you strength to endure. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Continue to remember our First Lady also. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We just thank the Lord for all the testimonies. Testimonies. It's good to be in the house of the Lord always.
Amen.
There's no better place you can be tonight than in the house of the Lord. It's good to have a desire to serve Him. There's no greater desire. There's no reward is better than what God has in store for each and every one of us.
Amen.
Amen. If we get together and let God have His way, If we get our minds focused on letting the Spirit of God lead us, guide us, direct us, in all that we say, think, and do, we're going to come out right on top, y'all. The Bible says, he that endure to the end. Hallelujah. Continue in the faith. We thank the Lord again for blessing us tonight. You didn't have to have strength in your body to be here. Somebody feel like going on. You're here tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. And I believe God's going to give us what we need. Even though our pastor, Bishop Polk, is not here tonight. Hallelujah. God always has a ram in the bush. And somebody that's worthy and knows the word of God. Amen. Amen. We have Minister Holloway here, Sister Rhonda Holloway. She's able.
All right. Preach the word.
With the help of the Lord, through the Spirit of God, to preach and to teach the word of God. Because in all thy gettings, you got to get understanding.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Your faith has to be built up in Christ. Hallelujah. It's more to it than just shouting, letting it out. But you've got to have it built up. And God has somebody that can do just that. Let us all stand and receive Minister Rhonda Holloway by the hearty. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All to this hand, God's unchanging hand. Hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Build your hope on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord,
saints.
Hallelujah.
It's good to see you in the house of the Lord on tonight. Amen. We're going to go to Hosea. As we know, our pastor is not here on tonight, but he is at home.
Amen.
Amen. He is on his way back. Amen. So we're, amen, lifting up his name in prayer on tonight. Yes, asking God for a quick, speedy, and full recovery. Amen.
Amen.
Also praying for the First Lady, because we miss her on tonight also. Amen.
Amen.
Asking God to give her strength. And all the saints of God that's not here for whatever reason. Sister McCullough, we see that's not here. But we know she was here on Sunday. It was good to see her. Deacon Whitby. Amen. Amen. And Sister Thomas, who we have not seen. Asking God to... Amen. We need to call and check on her. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to go to Hosea on tonight, chapter 6. In responsive reading, come and let us return unto the Lord, for he hath torn and he will heal us. He hath smitten and he will bind us up.
After 2 days, and the third day, he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight.
Then shall we know, if we follow on to know the Lord, his going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain, as the latter and former rain unto the earth.
O Ephraim, what shall I do unto thee? O Judah, what shall I do unto thee? For your goodness is as a morning cloud, and as the early dew goeth away.
Therefore have I hold them down, or hold them by the prophets. I have slain them by the words of my mouth, and thy judgments are as the light that goeth forth.
For I desire mercy, not sacrifice, and the knowledge of God more than burnt offering.
But they, like men, have transgressed the covenant. They have dwelt treacherously against me.
Gilead is the city of the work of iniquity, and it is polluted with blood.
And as troops of robbers wait for a man, so the company of the priests murder in the way by consent, for they commit lewdness.
I have seen a horrible thing in the house of Israel. There is a whoredom of Ephraim. Israel is
the Messiah. Verse 11 altogether. Also, O Judah, he has set a harvest for thee when I return the captivity of my people. Lord Jesus, we come before you thanking and praising you, Lord, for this night. We thank and praise you for this very hour. We thank you for the souls that enter in to hear a word from you on tonight. Help your servant, Lord Jesus, to decrease and you increase, Lord. Speak your word, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, let the hearers understand and let me speak with clarity. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Like I said, the pastor's at home. Amen. He is at home, so he is on his way back. We're just glad to be here on tonight and glad to see you, amen, still supporting the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to go to, amen, this has been on my heart for a couple of weeks now. Amen. We're going to go to Psalms 27. I'm going to start there. That will be my scripture reading for the text of the day. We're going to deal with God's glory on tonight. Amen. So I'm going to read Psalms 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. The war should rise against me, and this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock, and now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou saidest, seek my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help, leave me not. Neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over into the will of my enemies, for false witnesses has risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait. Everybody say, wait.
Wait.
Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen. The glory. One thing have I desired.
Yes, Lord.
And that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. All the days of my life to behold the beauty of the Lord. We're going to speak of God's glory on tonight.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
The glory of the Lord. What is glory? What is glory? Glory is a hard thing to define. But glory is the beauty of holiness. It is the essence of God. Essence is the substance and the attribute that makes an entity or substance what it is. An attribute means a quality or a feature regarded as a characteristic or inherited part of someone or something. So, in essence, is an attribute or a set of attributes that makes a substance or an entity what it is. The glory of the Lord. We want to behold the glory of the Lord. I was reading in the book of Chronicles, in the second book of Chronicles, Monday, and we talked about the temple that Solomon built. Amen. And after he had made the temple, the glory of the Lord filled the temple. Amen. They were one accord in one place with one voice, praising God. But the glory of the Lord filled the temple. We hear people say all the time that they can see God's glory in the place. It looked like a smoke cloud in the place. Amen. But the glory of God is the essence of God. And it's the beauty of his holiness. It is what makes God who he is. Hallelujah. We want God's glory to be in this house. We want God's glory to fill our temple. Hallelujah. We want attributes of our Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, you know, when we, you know, many of us are parents. Sometimes when we have, you know, most of the time we have two parents, and we have some type of characteristic or feature from one of our parents. I happen to have my father's smile in my mother's eyes. Amen. And my children have my smile in their father's eyes. Amen. So you have an attribute. If your father or your mother, he should look like one of them, amen, or somebody in the family, amen. Come on, somebody. If you don't look like somebody in your family, you should be a little worried. Come on, somebody. You should look like somebody somewhere in the family line, amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we want to look like our father, amen. We want to look like our father because we've been baptized in Jesus' name, filled with his Holy Ghost, amen. We have been adopted into the family. So we want to have the attributes of our father. We want to have the characteristics of our father. And what we think about when we talk about Jesus, the first thing come to my mind is love.
All right.
When I think about my God, I think about love. Love compelled God to come down here and die for us. Amen. He shed his blood on Calvary Mount because he loved us. Not because we were so sweet. Not because we were so good. Not because of nothing that we did, but because his love compelled him. We're going to go to Romans 12 because we're going to look for some attributes. We need to start looking like our father. We need to start acting like our father. We need to know what that is. Amen.
Amen.
I heard the pastor say one day he had his hand on the table and he looked at his hand, almost scared him because it looked like his daddy's hand. I can attest to that. I was in the mall one day and I used to wear my hair when I had long hair. Wore my hair up in a bun. My mother wore a fringe wig. And I was in the mall and I walked by the mall. And it was a mirror. And it was a little, the mirror was not that close to me, but it was in the distance. So when I walked by the store and I walked by, I was like, well, look at my mama down there. So I said, so I backed up. And I was like, oh, that's me. You know how you can get it out the corner of your eye, you're walking so fast. And I said, Lord have mercy, I got to change my hairstyle. I got to change this look, amen. I started wearing French rolls after that. Amen. I said, I can't be walking around looking like my mama this at this age, amen. It's all right to look like her, but I just don't want to look old, amen. Amen, come on somebody, y'all know what I'm talking about.
She don't look like
amen. And that was about 15 years ago. So she really didn't look old. Amen. Amen. But we want to have the attributes of our Father. When people come into this church, the glory of the Lord should be in this place.
Amen.
His God's attributes should be in this place. The beauty of God's holiness should be in this place. They should feel and see God in this place. When they see you coming, they should see Jesus. Hallelujah. When they see you coming, when they stand in your presence, they should say, it's something about you. Come on, somebody. We want God to fill this temple. We want God to fill this temple. Amen.
Amen.
We want to move out all that those things that's not like him and let God's spirit dwell. Amen.
Yeah.
We want to be able, amen, to draw people. You know, I remember back in the day, they say it all the time that you can see the smoke cloud and everything. But I don't remember a smoke cloud, but I do remember the power of God being in the house of the Lord. I do remember at altar call time that it wasn't like it is now. People didn't sit through altar call. People were coming to be baptized in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. If they didn't walk down that aisle, they were convicted in their seats. Amen. And they couldn't sit still.
Right.
Amen. The Lord, God was working on them. The power of God was so powerful in the place. Amen. That you couldn't just sit in God's presence and be full of sin.
That's right.
Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
You couldn't feel comfortable, amen, knowing that you did your dirt and come and sit week after week. You should not be comfortable, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I was talking to somebody today, and she said, well, I want to be me. I just got to be me when I walk into church. I don't want nobody to change me. I was like, well, what you go to church for?
Mm-hmm.
That's the problem with the world. The world wants the church to be like them.
Like them.
Amen. They want to walk into church and be comfortable.
That's right.
They want to come to church and be accepted just the way they are. That's not what the church is here for.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The church is to transform you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To transform you. You came out of darkness. You're coming out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. You're not supposed to sit here and just come week after week and no changes.
That's right.
That's not what church is all about. Church is not here to make you feel good. Amen. Church is here to prepare you for heaven. We're going to go into Romans 12. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. That's just reasonable. Mm-hmm. God laid down his life for you. You should be able to give your life over to him. Present your body a living sacrifice. What's a sacrifice? Something that's not easy. Come on, somebody. Something that you, this is a sacrifice is something that you don't ordinarily do. But you're sacrificing your time. You're sacrificing your ability. Amen. We need to learn how to give ourselves and our thoughts over to God. When you feel like watching TV and God is telling you, get on your knees and pray, that's a sacrifice. Mm-hmm. Get on your knees and pray. God wants to speak to you. God wants to talk to you. Amen. Fasting and prayer is a sacrifice. Mm-hmm. Amen. You got to bring this body into subjection to the Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. You can't just walk around doing what you want to do. You baptize in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, and then you're just going to do what you want to do. There's a preparation period. God is preparing us for greater. God is preparing us for greatness. Amen. He's preparing us for his body. Amen. For his purpose. Not your purpose no more. When we think about the life of God, when we think about thinking about God, when we think about an attribute or characteristic of God, he was selfless. He didn't think about himself when he came down from glory.
All right.
He was born in a manger. This is the King of Glory. Born in a manger.
Uh-huh.
Born in a barn. That's what it is. Manger sounds nice and pretty. He was born in a barn with animals. On some hay and some wood.
Uh-huh.
The King of Glory. In swaddling clothes. Swaddling clothes is rags.
That's what it is.
They got all these fancy words. People get lost. Amen.
Right.
They rags.
Break it down.
Amen. So he came and he humbled himself.
Hallelujah.
He humbled himself. We have to humble ourselves.
Amen.
Amen. We got to get out of, pastors. I see so many pastors now. It's funny to me sometimes. And sometimes, it's not. But I see them walk around with entourages. They have bodyguards. And, deacons ain't deacons no more. They're security guards, It's like, wow.
It's true.
Jesus didn't have no security guards. He had disciples, but they was following him and learning from him.
That's right.
But we see these men walk around, they give them the wrong image of what God is. Now, am I saying that pastors not supposed to live well? No, that's not what I'm saying. But that's not what you're here for.
That's right.
Amen. God didn't come like that. But they got jets. They got all kind of stuff. I just heard on the radio that one guy, he got four different services on one Sunday. I don't understand why you need four churches on one Sunday.
Right.
I don't get it. What's the point?
Money.
More money.
And that's what it is. It's become a status. It's become a big business. Church has become a big business. Amen. But we got to get out of ourselves and get into God's work. That's why souls is not coming in. That's why
right.
We don't have people convicted anymore.
That's right.
That's why the power of God is not in the house. Amen.
Uh-huh.
Because we're sidetracked about what we see and not about what God has done. Amen. We're not looking to our Father as an example. They used to have this thing. What would Jesus do? Nobody care about what Jesus did anymore. Amen. Nobody care about that no more. Amen. We're going to do this the way we want to do it. Come on, somebody.
It's the truth.
Amen. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is get into the Word of God. The Word of God is our map. The Word of God is our blueprint to heaven. The Word of God is somebody said, I heard somebody said, everything you need is in the Word of God. Every situation that you have, that you're dealing with, is in the Word of God. Got marriage issue, it's in the Word of God.
Word.
Amen. That's right.
God loved the church, and that's how the man should love his wife.
That's right.
Come on, somebody.
So.
It shows you how a woman should submit herself into her husband.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
The Bible has everything you need in it. You want to know how to make some money? God said what? Bring ye tithes into the storehouse. Come on, somebody. Everything you need is in the house of the Lord. God can fix it. But we got to believe God. We got to open up the book.
Yes.
We got to open up the book. We come on Sunday. We come on Wednesday. We go into our Bible class and we read. But we got to look for ourselves. We got to look in the Bible for ourselves. We have a good pastor. We have somebody who teaches us the Word of God. But we need to follow up on what he's teaching us.
Yes.
Because you know what? You're not just getting it for you.
That's
right. Somebody, you're going to be tested at work. You're going to be tested in the street.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's going to ask you something about what happened in Bible class.
That's right.
And unless you're paying attention, unless you're writing it down, unless you're getting it for yourself, you're not going to be able to repeat it.
Mm-hmm.
We got to take heed unto ourselves and to those that hear us. We're just not here for ourselves. We're supposed to be ambassadors for Christ. What's an ambassador? Somebody to go in God's stead. Somebody to go in his stead. Amen. I heard a missionary chairperson, she was looking for somebody to go in her stead. She wanted somebody to go in her stead to certain events she couldn't make. So she was looking for an ambassador for the missionary. God, we should be God's ambassadors. Where God can't go, God can go everywhere. But God is going to send us to some places. But we got to get into his word. We got to be transformed. We're getting comfortable here. Like the children of Israel who went through the wilderness. They were just supposed to be passing through.
That's
amen.
Right.
They didn't know. They forgot they were just passing it through. And what happened? They started to complain. They started to complain and murmur about what they didn't have.
That's right.
We got this bread from manna from heaven. We don't want this. Uh-huh. Amen. They came out of slavery. Hard work. Amen.
That's
being
right.
Whipped all day, but they complaining now because they're being conformed. This is not our resting place.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
We're just passing through here.
Amen.
We're just passing through here. Amen.
Amen.
This is not this earth is not our resting place. This earth is not our home.
No.
We're passing through. So when it gets tough and it gets hard, we're just gonna be here for a moment.
Mm-hmm.
We're not here forever. We got to keep it moving. For I say though, the grace given unto me to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according as God had dealt to every man the measure of faith. Don't get, so, you know, it's funny, though. When God starts to bless us, it's hard not to feel a little something. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
When God starts to bless you, he gives you strength. Amen. When God starts blessing your finances, you feel a certain way. I can take this money and do this. Amen. God can bless you with a ministry. And you'll take it all out of proportion.
All right.
I see so many so many singers that started off in the choir. God blessed them with a voice. To sing in a choir or a gift to play an instrument in church. And you see them leave the church. Amen. They go out on the road and wind up dead, overdosed or something or whatever. Amen. And they trying to figure out why they ain't happy. They try to fill that hole that they have in their heart. But they had walked away from their first love.
All right.
You can't walk away from your first love.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And they get caught up. God give you a voice to sing. He's like, oh, this sounds good. Let me take this on the road.
Mm-hmm.
No, God didn't take it. He didn't take it on the road. Those gifts are supposed to be used in the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Now, I'm not saying some of your gifts is not going to, God, you're not going to be able to use them in the world. But you, whatever you do in word or deed, do it all in Jesus' name. You can't take Jesus' gifts and take him out of it and use it for yourself. Come on, somebody. We can't take what God has given us, amen, and take it to the street. That's not what God, take it to the street for ourselves. We just ain't taking it to the street and drawing people into God. We're taking it to the street and drawing people into us.
That's right.
You know, because what happens is, even preachers, the Lord bless you in your ministry, and you think it's you. But it's God speaking through you. And you get caught up, you get all caught up in these people. They ain't coming to see you.
That's right.
They coming to hear a word from God.
Amen.
So we got to get out of ourselves and let God be God. We got to get out. We have to decrease and let God increase.
Amen.
Apostolic Church of Jesus, we got to show forth God's glory.
Yes.
We got to show forth who our Father is. We got to show forth who has saved us, who has brought us out of darkness.
Thank you, Jesus.
We got to remember where we came from.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were once on the outside of that door.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We didn't know nothing.
That's
and
right.
We came in and we know a little something. Now we're looking at them like, don't come over here. I ain't got time to be helping you turn no pages in no Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. We ain't got beside ourselves.
That's right.
Because we have filled up. I'm saved. And I'm on my way to heaven, and I'm so glad. That's all I need. I got mine. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What'd you say to me? Just that fast, we in turn. Amen. We can praise God all during service. And somebody said the wrong thing after service, and we ready to cuss them out.
That's right.
Come on. That's not God.
That's not God.
God is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. God doesn't change. Now, that's not, you didn't get that from your daddy. So you must have got it from the devil. God didn't teach you to change like that. God didn't cuss nobody out in the Bible. That lady came pushing, as she talked about the lady with the issue of blood. Amen. God was in a crowd of people. This woman touched him. He didn't turn around and say, don't you touch me. He didn't say that. But how many of us would be aggravated? How many of us would be like, don't you touch me?
Didn't he ask who touched me though?
He asked who touched him, not for that reason. He didn't ask for that reason that he was agitated.
That's right.
He didn't ask for that reason.
That's right.
But we're so caught up in ourselves. We're so tired. We can't even give a phone call if somebody is sick in church. Come on.
That's right.
God laid down his life.
Hallelujah.
God laid down his life, and we can't lay down our time. Mm. We can't. God laid down his life for us. 1 John 3:16 says what? Hereby we receive the love of God, for he laid down
his life
for us. And we can't lay down our life. Now see, that life don't mean that you got to die for everybody you meet.
Right.
But it means set your priorities, set your stuff aside for a minute, and think about somebody else. Come on, somebody.
That's right.
Think about somebody else. Y'all quiet on me. Don't get quiet. I don't want to sleep on me. Amen. The fourth verse, For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. Sister, where's that scripture is talking about God has given evangelists and gave preachers and teachers?
Okay, Ephesians.
Ephesians, could you get that for me? For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. Okay. We all can't be preachers.
Mm-hmm.
We all can't be preachers. We all can't be musicians. If we was all ushers, who would we sit down? Who going to be in line to be seated? If we going to be all nurses, who we going to get water to? If we going to be all choir members, who we going to sing to? It sounds funny, but it's real. We walk around here out of place sometimes. We all can't be deacons.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? We all can't be deacons. I don't want to be a deacon. Amen. Some things look more glamorous on the outside than they really are. Amen.
Amen.
I don't want to be a PK. Preacher's kid. Amen.
Amen.
You
don't want it.
We're many members. God has given us many different talents.
Mm-hmm.
If we look at our own bodies, we have hands, we have eyes, we have ears. We have different things for different purposes.
Right.
Everybody in here might not be. We got to find out what our purpose is in Christ. We might be just givers. Some of us just going to be able to give. And some of us are going to have a discerning spirit to be able to pray and to be able to talk to somebody. Don't be envious at someone else's gifts. Ask God, what's your gift? Be used in your purpose, in your place. Glorify your position. Amen. And how do we glorify God? By being the godliest person we can be in that position. To manifest Christ in the position that we're in. That's being glorifying that position. It's letting God use you in whatever position that you're in. Amen. It's somebody, the man said some great things Friday. He said, everybody not going to be famous, but everybody can be great. It might not be famous. Your name might not be known all over the world. You might not be known, but you could be great at whatever you're supposed to be doing. Amen. So don't worry about if nobody know you. It don't matter. God is not calling for all bishops first, all missionaries second to line up to go to heaven. That's not how it is. It's going to be the very least in the church. The last shall be first. And the first shall be last. God has no respect of person. We're fighting for position. We're fighting to be known. We're fighting each other, trying to get what? The devil have us fighting, because if we're fighting each other, we ain't working together. What I like about Nehemiah in the 4th chapter, in the 6th verse, the people had a mind to work. They had problems, Sanballat and his boy, every day coming, talking to them on the wall, trying to get them off the work, trying to get them to come down from the wall, talking about them. That wall ain't going to stand. If a fox run up, it's going to fall down. Just talking about them. Just trying to get them to stop. Just trying to get them to stop doing what they're doing.
Exactly.
Hallelujah. But the people had a mind to work.
Yes.
The people were listening when Nehemiah said, "Don't stop working. Continue to work.
Right.
If you have some trouble, blow your horn. Get the tool in one hand and the tool in one hand and the sword in another.
Right.
Be ready to fight and work.
Come on.
Work and fight.
Yes.
But don't stop.
Mm-hmm.
Don't stop. Amen, because we're not coming down, because we're doing a good work. This is a good work. We got to stop. We always pausing. Somebody always make us stop. Something always happened to make us stop. Because we keep listening to Sanballat and his voice. Amen. This ain't nothing new. The Bible teaches you. This book is written for our example. Because we're going to keep getting the same test over and over until we pass the test.
Amen.
Amen. We got to learn how to stop, to not be disturbed by the devil.
That's right.
The devil's going to keep doing what he's supposed to do. But it takes a little something. It takes some fasting and some prayer to be focused.
Amen.
It takes a mind that's going to put some time aside to study it. It takes something to be focused. Amen. You just ain't going to get a focused mind thinking you're just going to do it all by yourself. But it takes something to be focused.
All right.
And we need to do that. Sister Wren, read that for me.
You want it where?
Ephesians 4.
Okay, 11. You want 11 or you want
11.
7? And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God into a perfect man.
Amen. We're working toward the unity. We're working toward one body. We're working to become one. We got to think about our brother and sister as ourselves. If our brother and sister is hurting, we got to help them. And if we can't help them, we got to pray for them. Amen. But we need to think of, because if my toe hurt, I'm just not going to walk around all day and not try to fix my toe.
Right.
Come on. Hey, come on.
That's right.
I give you these simple things. I tell you these natural things so you can have a spiritual understanding, according to John 12. If I tell you earthly things and you don't understand, how can I tell you heavenly?
Yeah.
If my toe hurt and I don't do nothing to it, and I walk around and don't do nothing to it, what's going to happen? That toe eventually is going to affect my whole body.
Yes, sir.
It's going to kill my whole body if I don't take care of my toe. That little bitty thing in my shoe.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Matter of fact, the pastor's home right now because of that little bitty thing in his shoe.
Yeah.
Amen. That little toe, it took him down.
Amen.
Think about the body of Christ. Think about us and how we work. Amen. If we're not doing what we're supposed to do, if we're not taking care of what we're supposed to do and working in the area we're supposed to be working in, taking care of those areas that God has put us in, this body is not going to work right like it should. It's not going to move forward like it should. Amen. If my toe is hurting, I'm going to be in the bed.
Come on now.
Stand off of that foot.
That's right.
So if you are not in your place, if you're not taking care of what you're supposed to be taking care of, that whole body is what? Standing still. It's not performing the way it should.
Come on,
amen. Because we're not taking care of what we're supposed to be taking care of.
Right.
We've left something undone. Yeah. But we have to, as members of the body, work together on one accord, doing one thing, working toward one goal. Sister Ware.
Did you also, maybe you want the one also in Corinthians 12.
Go ahead.
Where it says, "But the body is not one member, but many."
I have that. Go ahead.
What you'll say, because I am not the hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? And if the ear should say, because I am not the eye, am I not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If the whole body were an eye, where were the hearing?
That's Corinthians
12.
1 Corinthians 12. Go ahead.
Okay. If the whole body were an eye, where were the hearing? If the whole were hearing, where were the smelling?
12 and 12.
Now I'm on 18 verse now. But now has God set the members, every one of them, in the body as it has pleased him. And if they were all one member, where were the body?
Come we on. Need everything. I watch the basketball players. Uh-huh. It's basketball season now.
Yes.
In order for that man to get that ball down the aisle or down the court, the hands has to work together, mm-hmm. the legs have to work together, mm-hmm. and the eyes have to work together.
That's right.
That ball, that the hands got to carry the ball, uh-huh. got to hold the ball, uh-huh. and the feet have to get it in motion, that yeah. body in motion,
yeah.
and that eyes got to keep a lookout to see which
say
way
it
we got to go.
That's right.
Come on, somebody.
Yes. That's right.
What if they say, no, I want to carry the ball? It wasn't the foot say, I want to carry the ball. No, I want to carry the ball. No, let me do that. Mm-hmm. That sounds crazy, don't it?
It does.
But it's just what we're doing.
Look at him.
It's just what we're doing. It sounds crazy, but it's exactly what we're doing. When we don't get in place and do what we're supposed to do.
Yes.
When we don't fall in place in the body of Christ, in your place, you got to be praying. You got to be doing what the pastor telling you to do.
All right.
The head has got to lead. You got to have signals from the brain.
Yes.
In order for anything in that body to work.
Right.
Now the pastor is supposed to get signals from God.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
How can we hear unless they have a preacher?
Mm-hmm. Come on now. That's
hallelujah.
The That's the word.
So if God is sending a man of God to give us signals, and we say no, we ain't doing that.
Uh oh.
Because I think the foot over there can do it. I don't want to do it.
Mm, that's crazy.
Amen. I don't feel like it.
All right.
That sounds real crazy. It sounds real funny. But that's exactly what we're doing.
Hallelujah.
That's exactly what we're doing. When we aren't obedient to the instructions that God is sending.
All right.
To the church.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And just being together. Do you know just showing up, you'll be blessed?
Amen.
Do you know just showing up, you will be blessed?
Come on
now. Do you know just showing up, you will
say
be blessed?
Say it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I look at so many things on TV. Just some things happen because you're in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Mm-hmm.
What if you being here tonight just saved you from death?
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
What's it, you know, anything. You never know.
You never know.
Just being here in the house, you just did. Being in God's will. Doing what God wants you to do,
yes.
It's going to bless you.
Amen.
You will be blessed.
Amen.
Just showing up, you will be blessed.
What's up?
Amen. You don't understand it now, but you will be blessed.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We got to get a mind of Christ. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus.
Yes,
the attributes, the mind of Christ was he came to love. He came because he loved.
Mm-hmm.
And when he got here, he served.
All right.
We got too many saints that think they're supposed to be served.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We got too many pastors that think they're supposed to be served.
All right.
We got too many people that's in titles and statuses that think they're supposed to be looked up to. But God came to serve.
Amen. Amen.
He washed the feet of his disciples. God washed the feet. And he said, I want you to do the same thing. I'm doing this so you'll do it for your brothers and sisters.
That's right.
He did it as an example. He kneeled. It's just an awesome thing. God got on his knees.
Yes, he did.
Jesus.
He had to get down.
Yes, he did.
To wash somebody else's feet.
Right.
And we won't even shake somebody else's hand.
Mm. Come on now.
We won't even humble ourselves to shake somebody's hand.
That's right.
God came to, he came because he loved, and then when he got here, he served.
Served,
yes.
He didn't come to be served, he came to serve.
That's what he said.
He came to work. He came to work.
Hallelujah.
He was focused. You didn't read about God partying in the Bible. He didn't stop up at this club.
Right.
He didn't stop over here and get some woman pregnant on the way.
All right.
You preaching now.
He didn't stop over here to feel, because he was in the flesh.
He was in the flesh.
Yeah.
He was in the flesh.
Yes, he was.
But he stayed focused. He stayed focused. He stayed focused.
Yes.
He was about his father's business.
Say it.
He was. He said he endured the cross.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm. He endured the cross.
Yes, Jesus.
For me.
Ah, my Lord.
Hallelujah. He endured the suffering.
Yes,
he endured the suffering. He endured the, them talking about him. He endured the pain.
Uh-huh.
He endured it.
Hallelujah.
He didn't. He wasn't the King of Glory to them. They looked at him as just a man. They spit on him. They beat him. They beat him all night long. But he endured it. Somebody said the wrong thing of us, and we want to stop coming to church.
Come on now.
But he endured it.
Hallelujah.
He endured the suffering and the pain.
Hallelujah.
He brought that body of subjection to that spirit.
Yes,
he said, no, you're not going to have your way down here. I got something to do.
All right.
He had the body in subjection to the spirit. The spirit came to die for his people. He laid down his life for us.
Hallelujah.
The same spirit that you have in your body, if you've been filled with the Holy Ghost, should be enough to take that body into subjection. That flesh should not overrule that spirit.
Yes.
And if the flesh is overruling that spirit, you need to fast some more.
All right.
That body is it's been shaped in iniquity. Amen. It went down to water, but that body is fighting the flesh. Amen. You can't give it an inch. It's going to take a mile. Amen. Come on, somebody. But God was focused. He came, he put the flesh was in subjection to the spirit, and he endured the cross. He came for a purpose, and that purpose was to save us. We should have the same purpose, the same hope, to see him face to face. Amen, not in anger, but we want to hear him say, well done, that good and faithful servant. So we being many are one body in Christ, and every one members one of another. Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to you or to us. Whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. Or ministry, let us wait on our ministry. Or he that teacheth on teaching. We have different gifts. And we learned, Sister Hope gave us a good word through her testimony. She said, having the grace is power. God give you power to sustain in all everything you were doing. And you got a ministry. If God called you to the ministry, don't rush it. Don't rush your ministry. If God's called you to the ministry, just keep coming, keep praying. And God will let the pastor know when it's time for you to get up and preach.
All
right. Amen?
Amen.
If God has called you to the ministry, you ain't gotta do nothing. God called me to the ministry many years ago, and I forgot all about it. And Elder Hope brought it up many years later. I haven't forgotten. But God doesn't work like that. God doesn't work. You've been called to the ministry. The next thing you preach it next week? No. Many ministers don't want to wait and sit and learn.
That's right.
Amen.
You got to learn. You will never be a leader if you don't know how to follow.
That's right.
You will never be a leader if you don't know how to follow. And if you do be a leader without following, you're going to have a hard time.
Come on now.
You're going to have a hard time. Amen? Why do I say that? Because as you're following, you're learning how to lead. You're taking notes from the leader. You're taking the notes from, and you've got to be, the Bible tells us to obey those that have the rule over us.
That's all.
Not only in the church, but in the world too.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Verse 8. Or he that exhorteth, or exhortation, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity. He that ruleth with diligence, he that showeth mercy with cheerfulness. These are all gifts. These are all gifts. Giving is a gift. Ruleth is a gift. Showing mercy. Let love be without dissimulation. Abhor that which is evil. Cleave to that which is good. Cleave to those things that are evil seem to be what our flesh wants to do.
Mm-hmm.
We seem to want to hang with the people in our family more than we want to hang with the people in the church. Why is that? Why is that? That we'd rather hang out with those that ain't been baptized in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We'll put the church down for those that's smoking, drinking, amen. We can't wait to get it with them. We can't wait because they funny. We're going to get some laughs. The people in church is boring. Come Come on, somebody. I ain't the only one in this church that I'm like that. Amen. We don't want to hang out with them. Amen. Because they ain't going to... What they doing? They're talking about Jesus. Go ahead, Jesus, enough. We saved now. This is saved folks talking like this. Amen.
It's true.
But they don't know how to have no fun. We just going to sit around and do nothing. Amen. Because people don't know how to be, they have not learned how to allow God to be God. You don't have to put on no show for nobody. Amen. You can be yourself. You can play games. You can play a lot of things. You can have fun. Amen. I have fun. I like to have fun. I like to have fun in the world. I like to have fun with my church family. Amen.
Amen.
And at the end of having fun with my church family, I ain't got no hangover. I ain't ready to punch nobody in the face. Amen. I ain't ready to lock my doors and turn off my phone because they ain't got on my nerves. Come on. Because you know, hanging out with the world and your family, even your family, get on your nerves. You say, no, people must be crazy. But the next time they call you, right there again.
Thank you, Jesus.
But we got to learn how to separate ourselves from some things. I'm not saying separate yourself from your family, but there are some things and places you should not go.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So there's some things you should not go. It says bad communication corrupts good manners.
Mm-hmm.
That's the word. Instead, you can't be around people that's always cussing and fussing and drinking and think that's not going to affect you.
Right.
It's some things I heard on TV and songs I can't get out of my head. So you thinking you're hanging around these bunch of folks that said all the wrong things, you think that ain't going to stick somewhere?
Mm-hmm.
It's going to stick. Amen. So we got to learn how to separate ourselves from some of those things.
That's right.
And teach the church folks how to have some fun.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Teach them how to play some games.
Amen.
We had to teach Sister Ware how to play some games. Sister Ware learned. She had.
Yes.
She was trying to cheat, but she learned how to play that game. She learned how to play that game, and we had fun.
Yeah,
you shouldn't try to cheat. She was trying to cheat, but we had fun, and it's good to have fun with your sisters and brothers.
Amen.
In the church.
Amen.
This is what we need to do. We need to come together, love one another.
Amen.
The devil tell you y'all boring. No, we not. Y'all don't see us when we are. We just like, we love to have laugh. We love to laugh and have fun.
Yes.
We like to do what you want to do, but we trying to get to heaven, so we can't do all what you're doing.
All right,
that's right.
I gotta stay focused. I gotta get to heaven. I can't be messing around with y'all no more. I can't. I remember, and sometimes it's funny when they get together. I'll be thinking, oh, I know what they're doing right now. They have me doing this. And I know what they're doing. I'd rather be with Jesus.
Yeah, hallelujah.
I'd rather be with Jesus.
Yes.
I can't go where y'all go no more. People get shot at the club. I can't go. They get shot on the way into the club. I can't do that no more.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. I can't do that. I can't go there no more.
Just pray.
They be innocent bystanders just sitting there and getting shot. I can't do that no more.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
My life is not that anymore. I'm changed and I'm happy about it now. There was a time when I wasn't happy about it. I wasn't happy. I was trying to try to play the fence. I'm still cool. I'm still cool. Look, I know how to do the hustle. I know all them hustles. They got 50,000 hustles.
Yes.
They got 50,000 hustles.
Yes.
They got 50,000. Sister Blandon, they got 50,000 of them now. They got to hustle for every song. Nobody dance together no more.
No.
They hustle on everything.
That's right.
And it's so funny that you want them to think that you're cool, and you want them to think that I have, I still like to have fun. I still like to have fun. No, we can do this. And the whole time, they real uncomfortable. They uncomfortable. You not uncomfortable. Just because you're trying to prove that you just as cool and you just as bad and you ain't forgot how to boogie and shake it down and shake it up. You ain't forgot none of that. Amen. You try to let them know, I ain't changed. And they telling you the whole time, yes, you have. I see something about you. You ain't changed. And they steady looking at you like this. And you just trying to make it, you just trying to bite yourself to prove to them that you okay. That you still fit in with the crowd. But we had to separate ourselves from that.
Yeah.
From that mind frame that I want to fit in with the world.
That's right.
You don't have to fit in with the world. God said we have to be transformed.
Mm-hmm.
Not fit in.
Transform.
Transform.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have to be conformed. And don't think that they're going to like you. Sister, I hear Sister Tracy all the time, I can't stand them people. They don't like me on my job. They're not going to like you. As long as you live in holy, as long as you standing for what is right, they're not going to like you. There's some people that's just not going to like you. And you just going to have to get over it and get past it and keep it moving. Because they're not going to like you. Because they see something about you. Don't worry about it. Don't get mad. Thank you, Jesus, and keep it moving. You got to thank Jesus and keep it moving. Because if you get caught up, you start getting mad back at him. You start playing that mad game. Y'all just, you want to start telling them they going to hell. No, don't tell them they going to hell. Just pray for them. You know, we fast to tell people they ain't, y'all ain't right anyway. But that's not our job to tell people they going to hell.
That's right.
Our job is to draw them to Christ. Mm-hmm. Not make them run from Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, you can't be telling people they going to hell anyway, so I ain't going to be bothered with them. That's what you're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You can't tell them. You got to pray for them.
Mm-hmm.
Pray for them and keep it moving. Amen. They're not going to like you. Just get over it. Amen. You're not going to fit in everywhere.
That's right.
But you know what? God can bless you. He'll let you find favor in some places. He'll have the right people not liking you. The right people liking you. Your boss will like you. And every all your coworkers will hate you. Hey. Amen.
Amen.
He's the only one that matters because he's the only one got the power to fire me.
That's right.
So we have to learn we have to get in our mind that we're not here to fit in. We're not here to stay. We just passing through. Be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love and honor, preferring one another, not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. Don't come in here slothful. Don't come in here dragging. Come on. We gotta have something about us. Amen. We gotta be excited about the Lord. We need to be excited about God. Amen. We need to be excited about what we have. Amen. Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer. Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer. Rejoicing in hope, patient. We got to be patient. Patient. How long, Lord? How long is patience? How long is too long? But God have forgot about me, so I'm just going to go and do my way. We got to wait on God. And in our scripture reading said, wait on the Lord and be of good cheer. Wait, I say, on the Lord. How long, Lord, do I need to wait till I say so?
All right.
Because he's in control. He knows what we need. He know how long we need to be in that situation. We might think, I got it now, Lord. I'm going to pass that testing this time. And you ain't ready to pass that test. You're not ready to pass that test. It was a movie I was watching. It's been years ago, but it always had a good meaning to me. It was Behind Enemy Lines. And this gentleman, he was in training, basic training. And he had been in basic training forever. Forever he was in basic training. I think he was overseas. And he would say, I want to be transferred because I want to get out there and kill some people. I want to get out there active duty. I'm tired of doing this. Well, he got his opportunity. And they left him over there behind enemy lines. They left him behind enemy lines. But because he had the training, the long training, he had extra training for some reason, he was able to endure behind enemy lines. But he had like an extensive period in basic training. And he said, I don't want to do this no more. I'm going to go out there and fight. Let me fight. And he was like, no, you have to learn this. There's certain things you got to learn. And he got his opportunity. He ain't asked for that no more. He got dropped off behind enemy lines. And when you dropped off behind enemy lines, they don't come get you. You got to find your way back. But he was able to do that because of his extensive basic training.
Uh-huh.
We feel like Apostolic Church of Jesus has been in some extensive basic training.
All right.
It feels like we've been working and practicing and building our muscle and nothing is happening. We feel like that we've just been coming and we're learning and learning, but nothing's happening, Lord. You know, this is a blessed church.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I look at the people here, and for the majority, nobody in here been really sick.
Amen.
Nobody has really missed a whole lot of church in this place. I look at this church. We have been a blessed church.
Thank you, Jesus.
God has sustained us. All that we've been through, we've been through three locations
mm-hmm.
and never missed a Sunday service. We've been up and we've been down. But God has blessed us and kept us.
Yes.
But God, when are we going to be blessed? We're already blessed.
Right.
We're blessed right now.
Amen.
Right now we're blessed.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're blessed right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
You don't have to have a big church to be blessed.
That's right.
You don't have to have a whole lot of people to get a word.
That's right.
The man said Friday, a man that had two big churches said, don't look for God in the big churches.
Big church, that's right.
He said, God could be in the small things.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah. But that's one of the things that hinders us. It gets us off track. We're thinking of why God has left us here and why we can't keep nobody. But Lord, just keep me. Don't let me wander too far. Don't let me wander too long. Because I don't want to know why they left. Because maybe I'll find out the hard way. Lord, just keep me sane. Keep my mind right.
Amen.
Keep me focused.
Amen.
Keep my heart. Keep my mind. Because I want to be saved.
Amen.
Amen. I just want to be saved. I just want to see Jesus in peace.
Amen.
I just want to see him when he comes back.
Yes,
I want to see him when he cracks the sky.
Yes, Lord.
I don't care if there's a bunch of us going. I just want to see him.
Amen.
You got to get to the point of what you're here for.
That's right.
Right.
What you're here for. I'm here just to see Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. I'm here just to see Jesus.
Yes.
And I've learned a lot along the way, but if I don't learn nothing else, and if I see him, I've got what I needed. I've made it. I've made it.
Hallelujah.
If I don't get nothing else,
yes, Lord.
And I get to see him face to face,
yes, Lord.
That's all I want.
Yes, Lord.
That's all I want is to see him face to face. Bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. Let me say that again. Bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. Bless them which persecute you.
Amen.
Bless and curse not.
All right.
That's hard to do. That's hard to do. But you need to bless them anyhow.
That's right.
Bless them anyhow.
Bless them anyhow.
It says, bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. Rejoice with them that do rejoice and weep with them that weep. Be of the same mind one toward another. Mind not high things, but condescend to men of low estate. Be not wise in your own conceit. Don't think you're so smart that you can't find or can't be taught anything. I'm not too young, I'm not too old not to be able to learn something. Somebody can teach me something. I remember when my dad and my mother got divorced and we went to stay with my father. And it was a culture shock because we were raised up at over here in Rosedale Park, near the Rosedale Park area. And when my dad moved over to the North End, that's a big, huge, it's a culture shock because we grew up over here with upscale people. Everybody worked, all the people worked. Both parents, kids, we went in the house at 6 o'clock. We didn't see no single parents. We had, it was like a Mayberry neighborhood, amen. So when we lived with my dad on the North End, there was bums on the corner. There was people sleeping on the corner. There was alcoholics walking around with two bottles in their back pocket. This was a culture shock. We sat on the porch for many a days just watching the people because this was like, what is going on? We thought we had just dropped off on the other side of the world. Amen. The North End was off the chain. And it was funny because my dad came from the North End, so he knew everybody. And so we were talking one day, and I was like, why do he always walk around with this security uniform and he don't go nowhere? And I was like, what is wrong with him? And it was a guy, I can't remember his name right now, but he was a guy that just, he was homeless. And my dad said, you know that man right there, he's a very smart man, an educated man. He had a wife, he had kids, and one day he just couldn't take it, he just left his family. He said, that man is very educated. And I was like, what? You mean he wasn't born a bum? I'm thinking in my mind. But my father taught me a valuable lesson, saying anybody can teach you something.
That's right. That's right.
He said, don't never look at the outside of the package. He said, because you're looking at him and thinking he's a bum, this man got more education than you got and me. But he had fell on hard times. He couldn't take it. Sometimes it's easier to say, I'm not going home. I'm just going to leave my family.
Too much pressure.
It's too much pressure. And that's what he did. He left his family. He left his job, his good job, his house. And he said, I'm not going to do it no more. I'd rather live on the street, collect bottles, beg for change. And he got to that mind frame. No responsibility. Do you know how many men I look at now and look and see? I was like, you know what? They just took the easy way out. They said, I couldn't take it no more. And so many times you think those people are, they can't teach you nothing, but you can learn from a bum. You can learn something from a man that has lost everything. So don't think so highly of yourself. Don't think that you're so much better than those people that you see on the street. These people can probably take a test better than you and probably got more letters behind their name than you do.
Come on now.
I met a doctor. I used to work in a therapy office, and this doctor, he was a medical student, and he had an accident. I didn't know he was a doctor because he came in, he had, he was like a surfer dude. He always had these like surfer clothes on. He looked like he just came off the beach. He had this blonde long hair, and he just looked like he was like, what's going on? You know, he was a real surfer, like, you know. I'm like, what's wrong with him? Because he seemed like a normal guy. This was a therapist's office. It was like, he has a closed head injury. He can't get right. But he was a doctor. A doctor. And I was like, well, I would have never guessed. I would have thought he was just an empty-headed, you know, guy. But we judge people based on appearances. Don't think so much of yourself. You never know who you're talking to. Me and my husband was looking at TV before we left, and they were saying this man just bought all this property up in Michigan, in Detroit. Did you see that? $3 million. I was like, he got $3 million? He don't even look like he got $3 million. But he got $3 million. He had came in. He about to do some great things.
That's right.
He about to do some great things. And if you look at this man, you're like, where he get $3 million from? Walking down the street, he does not look like a millionaire. He does not talk like a millionaire. But he got $3 million. He just bought up 600 properties in the city of Detroit. And not only that, he's about to make black people their own business owners. He's about to build up these neighborhoods. And you're looking at him, you're like, huh? Don't think so highly of yourself. Don't think so highly of yourself. Somebody always knows something more than you. Come on, somebody. Amen. We're going to get through because we're going to get out early tonight. Be of the same mind, one toward another. Mind not high things, but condescend to men of low estate. Be not wise in your own conceits. Recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourself. Rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine. I will repay, saith the Lord. Therefore, if thine enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirst, give him drink. For in so doing, thou shalt heap coals of fire on his head. Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good. Amen?
Amen.
Can we do that? It's going to take some time. It's going to take some effort. But we can do that because we got the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We got power. We got the glory of God. We have power, so we should produce, amen, some attributes of our Father. We should have some love. We should have some service. We should be serving one another. We should not have hate in our heart because there's no reason to hate you because you can't do, hating you is not doing anything for me.
That's right.
Hey, and they said, if you do right to somebody that don't like you, do you know they'll look at you like, what is going on? They'll stay away. They'll be scared of you. And she's killing with kindness. Amen. I know a lady at my job, I'm killing her with kindness. She don't even know what's going on. And she just don't know what to say. She just stopped coming up to my desk because she think I'm crazy. That's all right, but she don't mess with me no more. Sister Blanton.
All week long, I've been hearing the same thing about we should have a lot more going for us than what we do as far as getting out there and putting your problems and stuff like you should. Mm-hmm. Have faith in God.
Yes.
And stepping out there with faith. It's like the more I think about that and the more I look back on my life, I said, hey, I get to the place where I want to do it,
mm-hmm.
but it's like, how am I supposed to just do this thing?
You've got to do it.
You know what I'm saying? Because way back, a few years back, whenever I came into the church, I remember a lot of times the pastor would be saying certain things, And he would be telling me, you know, you should step out in your faith, or you should say this, or do this. And the more I did that, the more I could see God working in my life.
Yes, amen.
And I've gotten away from that for a while, you know, except for that storm and stuff that we have. I just got to get back into trusting God.
You
got to
trust him.
You know, all because right. In order for me to be able to do all these things that I'm being told that I should be doing,
uh-huh.
You know, I got to do that.
Yes.
I should be able to, regardless of where I'm at, I should be able to just do what the situation is calling for.
That's right.
If somebody's out there sick or something is getting ready to happen, I should be able to be in control.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
You got power. You have power.
Lord, help me to use my power.
Help you to use your power. God is not going to send you, God is not going to put you in a situation that you can't handle.
Right.
And you shouldn't put yourself in danger. I'm not telling you to go throw yourself in danger either.
Right.
But God is not going to take you places that God is not going to give you.
He's
not equipped you for. And I mean talking to people. Talking to certain people.
Okay.
And I'm not saying go up to talking to somebody that don't want to be bothered. Now, because God said also, if they don't want to hear, shake the dust off your feet and leave. Keep moving. But there are situations that you have power to do something about. And to witness in that moment. I was talking to a young lady at work. She's a white young lady. And she said, I knew what's something about you. You're a minister. And then somebody else told her I was a minister. I said, yeah, I don't just tell people that. She said, but I knew it. And she started, I witnessed to her for about an hour before I left. And so I started thinking, God don't have a respected person. God don't care what color they is.
That's true.
God don't care what color it is. And God gonna give you something to tell that person. It's a person that you may not relate to, but God's word relates to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
God's word relates, it surpasses money, it surpasses age groups, it surpasses color boundaries, it surpasses all of that. Because God's word is that powerful that I don't have to be able to relate with you, but I can feel your pain. I don't know about being in that situation, but I know pain when I see it. Amen. So I don't have to ever have to be a drug addict, but I know what pain is.
Amen. That's right.
But God has given us power. He's given us more grace to do his work. We got to learn to praise God. We got to learn to magnify his name. We got to learn to be transformed. We got power. When we look in the mirror, we get confused because we still look like that same person that we took down in the water and tried to bury it. Amen. But we should see Jesus. The world sees Jesus, and we still trying to make it look like Terry. We still trying to make it look like Rhonda. We still trying to make it like Flo. But God, but the world needs to see Jesus.
Amen.
The world needs to see Jesus.
Agree.
Not Rhonda. Not Sister Ware. But Jesus.
Amen.
When they see you coming, they should see Jesus on your mind, on your tongue, in your walk.
Yes.
We got to learn how to let God be God in us. In us. I hope you got something tonight.
Amen.
Amen. As always, we come tonight, amen, for our Bible class. Amen. Every night we come in, it's important to us to get a word out. Not just a word to help the church, but a word to go out to save people, to save souls. Amen. And we have water tonight, and we have clothing, and we have someone to baptize you in the name of Jesus. For the remission of your sins. According to Acts 2:38, it says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Acts 4:12 says, neither is there salvation in any name under heaven given among men, whereby we must be saved. There's only one name that brings salvation, and that name is Jesus.
Thank you.
And the name is Jesus. Amen. We see that there's not coming. We're not going to prolong the time. Amen. We're going to ask the deacons to bring the baskets. We're going to ask the ushers to give you an envelope if you need one. Please continue to pray for our pastor. Now, on Friday, that's children. The Sunday school department will be meeting here for Saints Night. They're celebrating Saints Night. Amen.
Amen.
Asking the children to come in biblical costumes. Amen. That means whatever costume they have, make it biblical. Amen.
Be a holy ninja turtle.
Amen. If she go be a holy ninja turtle. Go be one of God's creatures. Amen.
Amen.
If she's a princess in a movie, it's gonna be one of the Esther or Ruth or somebody in the Bible. Let me show y'all how to do this. Y'all gonna get them costumes. They can serve two purposes.
Amen.
They got to wear one to school. They got to wear one to church. Amen. We're asking them to come and try to be in biblical costumes. Amen. So that's Friday at 6 o'clock. We still need your help with that if you have candy. If you don't want to get the candy, please see Deacon Holloway. He will pick the candy up for you. Also, don't forget, amen, we're collecting money for flowers tonight for the pastor.
Right.
Amen, we're collecting money. Please see me and Sister Ware for money and sign the card. Amen, we have a card. Amen.
Sunday.
And Sunday.
Sunday
is Women's Day.
Yay.
Women's Day. Women, wear your green and white. Green and white is the colors for Sunday. We're having a potluck. Please see Sister Johnson if you have not signed up for a dish. Amen. Sister Johnson has something to say.
Oh, you just going to say that since we're all family and sometimes people have financial situations, please feel free to come anyway.
Amen. Please feel free to come in. Don't stay at home because you can't bring a dish. Amen. We're all family. Amen. That means the ones that's bringing something, bring